Hey, family, addict, named Kent. Now, I haven't shared my testimony in a while, so I'm going to do that. Today is the 27th. Choosing life. Change your self-destructive patterns of life. Become necessary. Active addiction is a submortality death wish. Each of us counted death every time we used. Our lifestyles took us to put us at risk. The life of an addict is sold cheaply and every day and even closer. In recovery, the first pattern we change is the pattern of using, staying clean for the start of a journey into life. But our self-destructive behavior usually wants far deeper than just our using. Even in recovery, we may still treat ourselves as if we are worthless. When we treat ourselves badly, we feel badly. And when we feel badly, we seek relief. Maybe in our old situation, drugs, choosing recovery means choosing life. We decide each day that we want to live and be free. Each time we avoid self-destructive behaviors, we choose recovery. I choose life. By choosing recovery, I will take care of myself. We can't take care of ourselves. We need a power, a God, to help us. Let me start from the beginning. I was raised in a Christian home, and I accepted Christ when I was 13. Elohim told me that I would be a great man, and this was also told to me by my Sunday school teacher, who went forward with me. I accepted Christ, and I heard the word from God that I'm going to be a great man. And my Sunday school teacher leaned over to me and said the very same thing. The next Sunday, the pastor preached on the preacher in the Bible. I walked with the Lord all through my high school years, or all through my public school years. And after that, right up until high school, I was beaten on a daily basis by my dad for standing in for my brothers, because I didn't want them to take the punishment. I learned that Elohim was not for me, because I didn't see how he could allow a child to go through that. I walked away and went toward the devil. Since Dad was the one at church and nasty at home, Sunday Christians, I call him. The pastors of the church said Mom and Dad could not join as members because my mom was married and divorced and remarried. So I began to hate the church. And I learned I wanted to fit in, so I started using drugs and drinking all through high school. I learned that Elohim, and even everything Elohim was. See, when I walked away from him, I was called to be a minister, and I was scared. I used my beating father as an excuse to run from God. I thought that how to use my temper to my advantage. I scared people into doing what I wanted them to do. I used by intimidation. Because I was such an angry person, I would have killed him because I had that much anger for my father. I became an enforcer for the bikers and mafia. I was clean a year and could not live with the guilt. So, I went to the police and gave them all my names. Two pages of crimes came up. The police officer asked me to sit down, and he went in the back. And when he came out, the sergeants with the sergeant, the pages were erased. Was I was into heavy drugs by then. I used LSD, heroin, cocaine, painkillers. This led me down a path of so-called Easy Street. I thought doing jobs for the bikers in the gang for the biker gang in Moncton. This only led to distractions and dangerous situations. I was a man up on the sand, and every time it rained, I was washed away. So, at age of 30, after attempting suicide, for the eighth time, I went to AA. I didn't like it. It didn't fit me. A friend took me to an NA meeting. It was a speaker meeting. I felt at home. And that was on April 7th, 1995. And I have never left. And by the grace of God, I have 22 years. Now, I am here. The prayers from Mum were answered. Elohim kept me from death 8 times. I now hear Elohim's voice again. I know I am on the side of the Lord. Why do you think this was hard? It's so easy to let go. And let God lead all the way. Pressure is off. No. Pressure is off. Now I'm led to his dreams and desires. It's much better on this side. God's way is now my way. His thoughts are my thoughts. Now, God has my whole life. Come see how it feels to be led, to let God lead. It has taken God 6 years to get me here, but now I love others and feel their pain much better than causing it. Now God has all of me. See God for the person he is, and not for what the whole world says he is. This is a much better life than doing it my way. Shalom. God gives us a way where there is no way. And when we actually let go and let God, it makes so much an easier life. Because I don't have to worry about my problems and issues, you know, anymore. Because they're taken care of by a God who loves me and cares about me and gives me that peace of mind. May God bless and keep you. Amen. I have a treatment page on Facebook. It will be on this link. If you need help, I'm willing to help you. I do grief counseling, addiction counseling, bully counseling, loss counseling, suicide counseling. Call me. I can help you. I've been through the whole rigmarole and problems and issues. May God bless and keep you. Amen.